Hey guys, I'm at the Vittala temple in Hampi, and I'm going to show you the mystery of the musical pillars. This structure, called the musical hall, is now closed for renovation. However, I managed to get the actual sounds from these pillars. Here's a pillar which shows a man playing ancient drums. Now, if you tap this, you will hear the sound of these drums. Now, here's the sound of a temple bell. And here is a sound similar to a school bell. Now, you can combine these various sounds to create even modern sounds. For example, this is the combination of the temple bell and the school bell to create the modern day doorbell. How do these different pillars create various sounds? But this is nothing when you take this pillar that's made of one stone and has small columns carved onto it. If you tap on each of these small columns, they create the seven notes of the musical scale in Indian classical music, which is similar to do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti in Western world. This is what it sounds like. What kind of stone technology existed in ancient India that could mimic the sounds of musical instruments? We can see many, many different sounds of advanced instruments like tarang, which uses water waves. Ghatam, which uses terracotta pots. And even sounds of string instruments are created on these pillars. How do these pillars, made of the same material, which is granite, create these various sounds? Is it possible that the ancient builders somehow created holes inside these pillars? Because the only way to make different sounds from the same material is to alter its density. So, do these pillars have holes inside them to enable them to create various sounds? The British had the same question in mind, and they not only took a huge pillar, but also cut one of the small columns to see what was inside. Here, you can see the column that is missing. This was cut by the British during pre-independence in 1930s, and they were surprised to find that all these pillars and columns are just made of solid rock. So, if there are no holes inside these pillars, how do you make them create different sounds? If they altered the dimensions like height, width, and diameter, you could at least make them sound a little bit different. But if you look closely, all the columns have the same height, width, and diameter, yet they create the seven different notes of the Indian musical scale. If they're all of the same dimensions, same material, and don't have holes inside, how do they create different musical sounds? The only way this could be achieved is by changing the intrinsic density of the pillars, by adding a new material to it in different proportions, like modern day alloys. Today, we melt various metals and add them in different ratios to create the desired effect. However, did ancient builders melt solid blocks of granite and mix it with other materials to create different sounds? Locals argue that the musical pillars were created using rock melting technology. As evidence, they say that chains made of rocks were hooked to these corners on the ceiling. Now, this would be impossible without melting the rocks. These rock chains were later destroyed during foreign invasion, just like the temple tower. A chain made of solid rock. Is something like that even possible? Why do these corners have empty hooks? Based on a tip, I traveled to Kanchipuram, which is 300 miles from Hampi. And here, we can see the chains hanging from the hooks on the corners of the ceiling. Yes, these chains with many links are in fact made of stone. Archaeologists have confirmed that these are made of stone and were created at least 700 years ago. How could anyone create these stone chains with primitive tools? Even today, such a technology is not possible with modern machines. What kind of machines were used in ancient times, and how were they able to create these chains made of rock? But this is not even the main problem. The problem is that while the stone chains are made of sandstone, the ceiling is made of granite blocks. So how could they connect two different types of rocks at this junction? We know for a fact that this is impossible without melting the rocks. There is no way to connect two different materials using links unless one of them is melted. So these rock chains prove that the ancient builders did in fact melt the rocks and changed its density like modern day alloys. Now let's go back to the musical pillars of Hampi. We can be sure that the rock chains were once hanging from the ceiling of the musical hall. Otherwise, there's no need for these hooks. Now, to create musical pillars, we not only require rock melting technology, but also enormous understanding of sounds. Did ancient builders have a much deeper understanding of sound, just like modern day scientists? Today, we use a technology called cymatics to understand sound and vibration. When struck with different musical notes and vibrations, different geometric patterns emerge. Is it possible that ancient builders were also using cymatics? And more importantly, are these patterns carved in the temple of Hampi? Here, you can see cymatic patterns carved on the ceiling of the Hampi temple. These carvings clearly resemble the patterns similar to the musical notes. Each musical note creates a certain pattern, and the ceiling of the musical hall is full of varying patterns. Even better, these carvings show sound in three dimensions, and today we can create 3D cymatic patterns of the same sounds using holograph technology. Is it a coincidence that these cymatic patterns are carved all over the ceiling of the musical hall? Why else did the ancient builders take enormous pains to create these varying patterns on the ceiling? Now, what's more interesting is that the musical hall is closed because people have damaged it by tapping the pillars with keys and coins, while in ancient times, musicians exclusively used sandalwood sticks to tap on these pillars. And if you look at this cymatics pattern closely, we see exactly what is going on. The women are standing in a circle, tapping with sticks, and the sound they create is visually depicted in the center. Now, let's go into the main chamber of the temple to see if we can find more evidence. This place is completely dark and infested with bats, but it once housed the idol of Vittala, the main god of the temple. The idol is gone now, but on the ceiling, you can see a very large cymatics pattern. What is the need for carving such an elaborate pattern on top of the idol in a dark chamber. So what do you think? How do these pillars create music? Did ancient builders use rock melting technology to alter the nature of the rocks? How else can we explain these rock chains made of sandstone linked to the granite hooks? How is this link possible without rock melting technology? How could one rock with columns of same dimensions produce 7 different notes? Why are these various patterns of cymatics carved on the ceiling of the musical hall? Please let me know your thoughts in the comment section. I'm Praveen Mohan. Thanks a lot for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.